Yeah,
I forgot you don't have a PlayStation 4 yet.
What do you mean? Right, so I mean, he's in the party.
Now, listen. Now, if you're trying to do it in Assassinate, then you can unlock and lock back on. And
no,
then
no, that's garbage. That's child's play compared to what I'm going to tell you, Blades. What I'm going to tell you, I used it at tournament level in the Nothing Is True tournament, and I know it works. There is a reason why during the tournament I wasn't using a smoke bomb as much. During my earlier training, and even during the qualifiers of the Nothing Is True tournament, I was using a lot of smoke bomb because I needed a way to deal with knives. But then after I learned that, I realized that because all of my opponent's inherent weakness was shield, and because this guy is just so much effective in deathmatch, then I was better off using this guy's shield for the most part rather than smoke bomb, because I could perfectly counter knives without much of an issue.
So you do know about the locking and unlocking, how you can do the ninja.
Yeah, but that's been something that's always been there since Brotherhood, so no, it doesn't really have anything.
I'm not very good at it. I know it's there, but I'm not very good at it.
Yeah, it's kind of difficult because in this game to unlock, you have to lock somewhere else. So if you have manual camera, it kind of becomes a little easier, but because I don't play Assassinate, I don't really care about it. For Assassinate players, it will really be useful probably, but not for me. By the way, I'm actually gonna give you a little other hint as to how to set some options to improve your locking, first of all, because to be honest, I mean, too many people in this game, they have locking problems, and I guess
that's because they changed the locking a little bit. The locking was perfect in Assassin's Creed.
No, I mean,
it was about 90% perfect. Now the locking is a little bit off.
Not really. The thing is that
you really
have to change an option to understand what's going on and how to perform better locking and never lock the wrong person. So yeah, let's start with the lock before we proceed with knives. Although I'm pretty sure that everybody really wants to hear what I'm gonna say about knives. Anyway, with the locking system, the thing is that the default options press start on your screen, Blades, and go to options. Go to you okay?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Alright, go to controls, and you're gonna see there that you have three options at the end, which they do actually affect gameplay. They're not like the previous one, which are usually personal preferences in terms of sensitivity and the directions of the accesses, but they don't really, other than affecting your performance if you're used to playing in a given way, they don't really change anything in game. Whereas the last three options, they do change things in game. Manual camera is a little similar to the previous one, but it gives you ability to do things that you cannot with the default camera. Now, the thing is that depending on the mode that you play, manual camera may or may not be convenient to be turned on. So it really depends on what mode you play. I play Deathmatch, and I really find it more useful to have it off, which is the default, rather than on, which is how mostly Assassinate players and like high-paced modes probably would benefit from a manual camera. But Deathmatch is not really a fast-paced mode. I mean, it is fast-paced only in the sense that you die a lot and you kill a lot of people, but it's not fast-paced in the sense that there is a lot of running. There shouldn't be a lot of running. There's probably a little rush here and there, but it's not generally a fast-paced mode. So I set it to off. Now, with what I was going to say is that there's two really important options at the end of the options screen. First one is precise aiming assist, and the second one is jump assist. Precise aiming assist is a difference. It makes the default is on, and what precise aiming assist does is that if you hold your trigger button, your lock button, and there is a civilian in front of you at the time that you hold the lock button, your lock will automatically follow on the NPCs or players. They could be players as well. It will automatically like lock on them and kind of like follow them as they walk. That's usually, at least after you are playing at a competitive level, that's usually an undesirable trait of the lock, because it will sometimes mess you up as you are trying to lock a specific person by swiping your reticle across the screen, and then you end up locking a civilian, which is not what you intended to do. So, but we're gonna show both blades so that they see the difference. So leave it to on, as you probably have it to on, and I'll show you.
No, I had it off.
Okay, you have it off. Then that's great. But yeah.
So you want me to put it on?
Yeah, put it on just so that we can show people what the difference is. And then finally, there's jump assist, which is default to on as well. Jump assist. It depends on your playstyle and how you play, but for me in particular, I rather have it to off because it kind of messes me up a lot of the time. So what jump assist does is that
it takes you right to where your target is.
Yeah, exactly. Jump assist basically, if you lock somebody and jump, and you jump in the general direction where they are, instead of jumping
over them, an acrobatic or something.
Instead of jumping across. Across to the other side, what you do is that you jump straight to your target. That was kind of useful in AC3 because drop stones were, I don't know, I guess a reality of the game, albeit, in my opinion, and that's really my opinion, it's not something I can really formalize on, it was lag-based. That's my opinion. But, in any case, in AC4, drop stones, I mean, they're really rare, and it's uncommon. It's really uncommon. So it doesn't really. I mean, if that was the real purpose that you had it on for, it doesn't even matter on AC4. But again, always check the mode that you play and decide based on that. Anyway, the reason why I have it to off is that I tend to. Give me a sec. Okay, so the reason why I tend to have it to off is because it is rather common a situation where your target is below you and there's usually an obstacle across and you can jump and get an acrobatic. So to be honest, 90% of the time that is the case for me, and I got messed up by that. So in the end, I just decided to turn it to off, and as well as precise aiming assist. So now just press the start button again and go to the game. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show what the problem is with precise aiming. Just look somewhere, Blades, where you see that an NPC is going to go, like going to walk through. It can be a group or it can be a single NPC. It doesn't matter. And you're gonna hold the lock so it zooms in, and then but stay put, so it is more obvious to them that your camera is moving on its own, like you're not the one moving it. Just look in a specific direction where an NPC is going to go through.
I see. And as you have the button held, it follows them.
Yeah, it follows them. So the problem is that sometimes it happens so quick, and it happens in high pressure situations that... let me show it myself because, I guess after all, people are also going to watch my point of view on YouTube later. Let me go to... precise aiming assist on. So all right, so let me just stand here and lock over there. So look as it's automatically
like a walking target.
It has to be a walking target, so it's more obvious. I was automatically locking a Havel there, but I'm gonna fix it there and see how my camera just literally turns around and it's following in this case.
That is so not good. Like you said, when you're under pressure and you're trying to get the right lock, if you got the camera moving from left to right, follow this one,
The problem is
a big no-no.
Yeah, and the problem is that
for me anyway.
And the problem is that in a high pressure competitive match, sometimes you really have to swipe motion lock people. Like you're running and you just literally swipe the reticle over people in order to lock them. Or what's even worse, sometimes you see that your target is walking in a given direction and you can like move the lock in such a way that you're anticipating where they're gonna be in order to lock them, but just because a blend group just happens to pass by and go in the opposite direction, your lock gets dragged in the wrong direction,
right.
And that just literally screws you up and makes you lose some time. And that 1 or 2 seconds that you have to just relock again, that gets you killed. Or, you know, or
yeah.
You just don't get... sometimes you even kill a civilian, what's even worse. But, yeah, the thing is that it's a really general advice for people watching the stream that you should really disable. Just really disable that, because it doesn't help you for anything. I mean, maybe...
Not
I don't know, it just messes you up. So that's like...
Yeah.
40% of the reason why a lot of people say, oh my god, AC4 locking system sucks, and blah blah blah. Secondly, we're gonna explain how to over prioritize the lock compared to quick locks, which come up on decoy and when players are running. I'm gonna quickly make a set with decoy.
Should I turn it off?
Yeah.
Turn my camera,
yeah.
My manual?
Yeah. You can turn it back off. It doesn't matter for what we're gonna test now. And also, I want you to make a set with decoy so that we can test it the other way around. Like, I can show them on my screen what I'm talking about as well. So try to do that.
Okay.
We still have 20 minutes, so don't worry about it. Just take your time.
Funny. I don't have a set with decoy.
Yeah, neither do I, so don't feel too worried about it. Oh yeah, well, and in any case, let me just quickly show people on my screen that when it's disabled, even if you fix your lock, it doesn't follow anybody. It doesn't matter who goes through. If your camera is not set to with precise aiming
right,
assist, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't move at all.
Decoy. You want me to send a decoy out?
Yeah, but let me first give the explanation, because it's going to be pointless if they just see a decoy running around. So, first of all, the thing is that, as you guys know, when decoy and other abilities that trigger civilians, such as bodyguard, go out, or also when players are running and they're your pursuer or your target, you know that there will come up a prompt above their head, which is a quick lock, as we would like to call it, or the easy lock. So the thing about the easy lock is that it can really mess up what you're trying to do if you react inappropriately when they come up. So you really have to learn how to, instead of just using quick locks all the time, because quick locks are messy. They're just a help for newer players that don't know how to play, and give them a hint that they can lock people and that it helps them, well, that locking itself helps them. But as a professional competitive player, or even as just a regular competitive player, you really have to understand that this is not the right or the most appropriate way to lock people in many scenarios. So what we're gonna do is show what the difference is between the hard lock, as some people like to call it, and the easy lock, or the soft lock. So, the thing is that when Blades sends his decoy now, well, it's not really gonna be visible on his screen because, well, it's gonna be me, but then I'm gonna send the decoy at Blades to show the same example. When Blades sends his decoy at me now, if I immediately press the quick lock button, it will lock the decoy. But say that I didn't want to lock the decoy, but rather lock the real player. If I use a quick lock, that's gonna be utterly impossible, because it's just gonna keep locking the decoy all the time, because the decoy is in high profile, and Blades, who just happens to be standing in a group, is not in high profile. So I'll probably end up making a mistake and just killing the decoy, unless I get really lucky and my auto lock just happens to kill Blades. But if I'm far away, or if there are many civilians in the way, then that's not likely to happen. In any case, Blades, try sending a decoy at me, and I'll lock you. Yeah, so I just locked you pretty much flawlessly by holding the button down and just locking
you. You gotta hold the button down and swipe it over, because once they go in high profile, as soon as you hit the lock button, it's gonna go to whoever's in high profile.
Yeah,
so
to be honest,
that would've been the decoy right there.
Yeah, to be honest, you don't really have to swipe it, and especially not if they're standing or if you have smooth control of your lock. Like, you really know that you have them locked, like you have the lock in the right position to lock them. But you do have to wait a little bit until the camera zooms in, and when the camera you're sure that the camera has zoomed in enough, then you can just release it. When you get used to it, it's a really quick motion, and it's almost as fast, not as fast of course, but almost as fast as a soft lock. But the thing is that it is dead on accurate. It will definitely lock the person who was highlighted at the time. Because yes, for those
but
of you,
so you're saying that it has to, you know, you gotta hold the lock and aim it at the direction of the real player. Because if you just try the quick lock, it's just gonna target the decoy.
Yes, exactly. And this is a great mistake by many players. And also another thing that you can do is that, and this technique is actually called used in other games like in shooters, especially in shooters such as Uncharted 3, and I'm not sure others, that even if you're not aiming with your gun, there is a small dot in the middle of the screen, which is like the position of the reticle. It's like, if you hold the lock or the aim on those games, you know that the... Whoa. Who the hell is this guy? I just got killed.
Hey, Plex, hold on a second. Sorry about that.
It's all right.
Okay, go ahead. Just pick up where you had left off.
Alright, so, well, yeah, I was saying that with time you get used to this quick, you know, zooming in and doing a hard lock. Initially you may have trouble with it because, well, you really have to practice it. Everything comes down to
so
practice.
What you're saying with hard lock is that when a player is zooming in with the lock button and he is absolutely determined to lock on to that one person, and once he feels that it's zoomed in and locked on perfect, that's when he lets go of it.
Yes.
As opposed to the quick lock, where a decoy runs by, somebody's in high profile, it gives you the prompt, press the L2 button, and then immediately they press it and let it go.
Yes.
That would be the...
The soft
right,
lock.
So that's
that would be...
New players.
Yeah, that would
that's
be the soft lock. Yeah, and
but
I think
the hard lock, what...
Yeah, the hard lock is the one where you zoom in and then release.
Right.
And then release the lock.
Right.
And this is actually,
exactly.
I think, the generally accepted terminology amongst the community. So it's not like I'm making that up.
No. You're right. That works. I mean, that makes perfect sense. But like for the new players that might not know it.
Yeah,
you know?
I know. That's why I'm saying it. That's why I'm saying it and explaining it at the same time. In any case, let's just proceed with the next topic because we're kind of dragging on. And I'm gonna send a decoy so that they can see it from your end. By the way, this is a moment where it becomes even more important to have precise aiming assist disabled, because when the decoy runs at you, and if you have precise aiming assist, then when you zoom in your camera, remember that the precise aiming assist kicks in. And
it's gonna take away.
Yeah, it's gonna follow the decoy, which will make things even worse. Mm-hmm. And that's why people, yeah, that's why people say like, oh, this fucking lock is so stupid. It doesn't respond to what I do, and blah blah blah. Yeah. So that's the thing. Like, I understand that people don't know, but yeah, that's basically the explanation. Anyway, here goes the decoy blades. I'm gonna
wait,
do this.
Wait, hold on. Did you want me to do it with the precise camera on or?
No. We don't need to do it that way because after all, that's the wrong way to do it. So we just really want to show them. I'm pretty sure that everybody has killed a decoy on accident, so they're gonna know what we're talking about. Here's a copy of me, so I don't. Well, I really want to go somewhere else. Oh, yeah, here. This is a better spot for the task that we want to do. It's gonna be a little complicated because, well, my copy is in the middle between you and me, but when the decoy goes off, try to zoom in, move a little to the side maybe, if necessary, and then lock me, Blades. So here we go. 3, 2, 1.
So see, right there, that's the soft lock. It locked onto him, but see, now I could get the hard lock on him by holding it down and just moving the camera with him and making sure that it's him right there. You see
all
that?
Right. So you wanna...
So that's a hard lock. I'm saying that's the one. That's the one. I'm sure. And then boom, I lock, and that's how I get the hard lock.
Yeah.
Okay?
Wanna do
so
it again?
Just do that again. Now I showed them the soft lock. Let me show them how to avoid that decoy.
All right,
let's avoid locking onto that decoy.
Yeah, let's go to somewhere where there's another copy of me so that the example is more predictable. Because Well, okay, it's gonna transform one of these two. So, yeah, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Well, see, he just called it. Now look, see, I'm locked on him. The decoy ran by me, but because I held the L2 button down for like two, three seconds, the decoy just ran by me, and I was able to lock on to the one of the real target instead of the decoy. So if I were just to hit L2 once, it's gonna just lock onto that decoy, because you know they're not gonna tell you that he's the real one. They want you to assume that it's the decoy. So if he goes running and you press that L2, it's gonna lock onto that decoy. You gotta hold it and get that hard lock to get the proper target.
Yeah. So finally, I was gonna say something in this regard, and I kinda forgot, to be honest. So in any case, you really have to be aware who the real target is, because, well, if you don't know who the real target is, then you're probably gonna be messed up. But ultimately, I have something else to show you on how to pick decoys. And this is actually far more interesting than all of the things I have said now. Okay, Blades, so I'm gonna run right now, Blades, and I want you that first unlock me, first of all. I mean, in case you have me locked. And
no, I unlocked you.
Well, no, actually,
unlock now.
Yeah, okay, lock me now, lock me. Okay, so you look at the color of your lock. What color is it? Is it white, right? It's white?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm gonna break your lock by going over here. And I'm just waiting for your lock to break. Alright, I guess it should have broken by now.
Yeah.
So, okay, now, look at me, and I'm gonna run in high profile. Do not lock me just yet. But when I run in high profile, the prompt's gonna come up. I want you to lock me and tell me what the color of the lock is.
It's blue when you're in high profile.
No, it's not blue because I'm in high profile. It's blue because I'm a player and because I'm your target. Now we're gonna do this the exact same example, except that I'm going to be your pursuer and you're gonna lock me after I run in high profile. Now, lock me.
Right, now it's red.
Alright, now we're gonna do it again, and this time you're gonna be my pursuer, right? So, lock me. Okay, so now I'm gonna send a decoy at you, and, well, actually there's a problem because this is assassinate, and when you unlock me and lock the decoy, it's gonna remove me as your target. But what I'm explaining here, it is entirely valid for all other modes. If you want, just feel free to go to those other modes, and with a friend, just test it out. But for the time being, it's gonna be the same principle, and we're gonna test it later with as a pursuer, and you're gonna see that it still works. It doesn't matter that you release the lock or not. So let's see who you are. You are that one. All right, decoy. When the decoy goes out, Blades, just lock it with a soft lock. It doesn't matter if you do it with a quick or a soft or a hard lock. It doesn't matter. But look at the color of the lock. There it goes.
It's blue.
It's blue? It shouldn't be blue. It shouldn't be blue.
Yeah, it's blue.
Well, thing is that...
Of course it could be... because remember, it's assassinate
mode,
so your decoy is not my pursuer, so it's
not
red.
No, but wait a sec. Let's do it the other way around. Oh, no. Well, let me check something. Yeah, send a decoy at me, Blades, because I think then that assassinate has different rules for this. But send a decoy at me, please.
Are you on the bench? Just
release it. I'm right beside you. I'll lock it as soon as it runs. Just release it.
Blades.
It is not
connected as your.
No,
it's
Blades,
not
but
connected as a part of the contract system right now.
Yeah, Blades, but
it's assassinate and the contract system is open.
No, Blades, but I think you misunderstood what I tried to explain before. Allow me to explain.
Okay.
I didn't ask you what the color of the quick soft lock prompt was. That's not what I was talking about before. I was talking about when you lock a person, there appears a little lock icon above their head. So it's kind of like a keyhole. It has like a keyhole, right? So
mm-hmm.
That's what I was talking about. I was talking about the color of that after you lock them. So you have to lock them first. And then look at the color of the lock icon above their head. That's what I was trying to say. So in any case, we're going to try it again.
Yeah.
We're going to try it again. Okay, first of all, let's do it with me. With if it's still different, then Assassinate definitely has different rules with this. But I'm pretty sure that for Deathmatch and other modes,
so
it works.
Now when you send the decoy, now it should be red when I lock on. Unless when I break...
It should be white.
My profile. Maybe...
No.
Okay, go ahead.
Release the lock, first of all. Release the lock. All right, now, and then lock me as I am in high profile. Do it with the quick lock, of course.
Now
so
it's red.
It should be red. Now, release it again. Now, when I send the decoy at you, it will show a prompt, a red prompt, for the quick lock, meaning it's a pursuer. But when you actually lock it, you'll see that the lock icon above their head, it's gonna turn white rather than red. So that means it's a decoy. It's not a player. So if you see that it's a blue or a red icon, that means that the person you locked, it is a player. But on the other hand, if you see it's white, that means it's a decoy. So here goes, Blades. I'm gonna send it from here where I am. So there it goes.
It's red, now it's white.
Yeah, you see that it is white? Alright, you see that?
It was red when you launched the decoy. It was red to give you the illusion that it was your pursuer coming to kill you. But upon locking, when it turns right, that's when immediately you should realize that it's not your pursuer.
Yes. So this is one way to pick up decoys, and it works both ways. Like, it works even if you're a pursuer or a target. Okay, Blade, so just quickly, I already locked one of you, but lock me to become my pursuer and send one decoy after me just so I can show the same thing from my side. We can do it just real quick because the explanation is already there, so we don't really need to explain it again. Launch it. Okay. As you guys can see, the lock icon above his head is white, even though he presented a pursuer prompt first. Now, Blades, please run a bit, just so I can hard lock you, or quick lock you. As you guys can see now, the lock icon above his head is red, and that's pretty much it. Alright, Blades, I think we're good with that, and let's proceed with the next thing, which is knives. We only have 2 minutes, so yep. I actually think I'll just back out because there's just not gonna be enough time. And that's good. That's good for one video, I think. So I'll probably.
I think so.
Yeah.
I think that came out really well too.